HIMARS is getting closer to getting another ammunition that's expected to significantly enhance its lethality. Extended range, or ER-GMLRS test, has been conducted at the White Sands Missile Range in New Mexico. A HIMARS was used to fire the rocket, which flew to its maximum range of 93 miles, or 150 kilometers. This is the first time a flight trajectory this long was achieved with this rocket. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how HIMARS will become even more potent with ER-GMLRS. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Jay Price, Vice President of Precision Fires at Lockheed Martin Missiles and Fire Control, said, "This test demonstrates nearly double the range while maintaining the precision GMLRS is known for." He added, "Lockheed Martin is committed to advancing this critical capability on a rapid timeline for our Army customer, and this test moves ER-GMLRS one step closer to fielding." Lockheed Martin stated, "The product also successfully integrated with HIMARS and achieved overall missile performance." Separately, something called Stockpile to Target Sequence, or STS, testing was performed. As per Lockheed Martin, this effort simulates cumulative effects ER-GMLRS will meet in the field between factory and launch for the life of the system, and demonstrates durability of the missile and launch pod container. The M142 High Mobility Artillery Rocket System, or HIMARS, is a light multiple rocket launcher developed in the late 1990s for the United States Army, mounted on a standard M1140 truck frame. M142 HIMARS has one universal pod that can currently accommodate 6 unguided or guided missiles of 227mm caliber, or 1 MGM-140 Army TACMs with a diameter of 610mm. At present, HIMARS has 3 main types of ammunition. 1. The vehicle can fire standard rockets at a maximum range of 28 miles or 45 kilometers. 2. With GMLRS or guided MLRS, the system can reach a land target at a maximum of 46 miles or 75 kilometers. GMLRS integrates a 90-kilogram or 200-pound unitary warhead. Guided MLRS rockets have a reliability rating exceeding 98%. 3. It can strike 186 miles or 300 kilometers with the MGM-140 Army Tactical Missile System, or Army TACMs. The Army TACMs weighs 1,670 kilograms or 3,680 pounds, develops a maximum speed of Mach 3, and has integrated a system for GPS-aided inertial navigation guidance. It is the most potent armament for the system since the Longer Range Precision Strike Missile, or PRSM, which will have a much longer range, is still under development. ER-GMLRS slots in between guided MLRS and Army TACMs with 93 miles or 150 kilometers range in all weather conditions. As per Lockheed Martin, ER-GMLRS shares commonality with legacy GMLRS and is deployable by HIMARS and the MLRS M270 family of launchers. The rounds incorporate a larger motor and have enhanced maneuverability due to tail-driven control. A fact sheet published by the company does, however, reveal a plan to update the missile's launch pod design with the ability to accommodate future variants up to 10 inches in diameter. The pod's compatibility with legacy GMLRS will not be affected, and both the ER-GMLRS and their new pods will be compatible with HIMARS and MLRS M270 launchers. The brochure also notes that the ER-GMLRS warhead will not deviate from the earlier GMLRS existing unitary and alternative warhead options for fixed-point targets and fixed-area targets, respectively. HIMARS has been one of the most impactful weapons the U.S. has provided to Ukraine. It's been used to blow up Russian ammunition depots, command and control centers, bridges, and even air defenses. Targets that were beyond the Ukrainian strike envelope earlier were decimated with HIMARS. The unique selling point of ER-GMLRS will be that it will have a 2x range compared to current guided rockets and can be loaded as a set of 6, unlike Army TACMs and PRSM. It's unclear when the ER-GMLRS will be deployed in service of the American military and its allies, but Lockheed Martin says it expects a rapid timeline. The U.S. military will surely get a boost with its induction.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.